Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to another video. I decided to try a new game called the Lions Game, which I've actually never heard of or never even like seen before, but I just found it on Steam, and I think it was actually free for the first episode. I don't know what they're going to be doing for the next episodes, but I wanted to try and check it out. I think it's like story driven. I think it's kind of like a visual novel, but it looked pretty interesting, so I'm going to give it a shot. First episode is called Silence. Milk train station. Do you have enough socks? You need plenty of socks. It's very cold there. Mama, you packed the suitcase yourself. It's stuffed with socks. All aboard for Vienna. You will write your mother, won't you? Every day, Papa, I promise. You're such a liar, but I love you anyway. Interesting. All aboard, last call for Vienna. Mama, let the boy go. Oh, it's these guys talking over here. He will get in trouble if he's late. My dear boy, take care. Yes, Mama and Papa, you take care too. Take care. Wilma first left them on this very train. Now me. For some reason, I imagine they were talking to, like, a little boy. Vienna Musikaka Demi Corridor. Oh, okay. Myself. Arthur's desk. This is really interesting. Arthur, where are you? You asked me to come to your office. Here I am, waiting. Maybe, at last, you want to talk. About us? But you're so shy, Arthur. You don't know how to begin. Oh, don't be silly, Wilma. You keep hoping it will happen, but it never will. Oh, shit. I'm glad you're here. I just had to see you. Sorry I'm late. Why did you want to see me, Professor? Please call me Arthur. Why did you want to see me? Well, to be quite honest, yes. Wilma, your performance at the salon. It was quite incredible. The guests could not believe their ears. Oh, yes. She seems kind of sad because she's trying to figure out what's going on between these two, so I'm going to kind of do a more solemn option, I guess. They seem to enjoy the music. They want to hear more from you, Wilma. We need to keep up the momentum. How is the new composition coming along? It's more difficult than the others. Oh, I like her facial expression. Your music is so new. It entices, it challenges. I know that we are about to achieve something great here. The future of music. Arthur, we must build on the success of your performances. If we stop now, we'll squander this opportunity. We have to keep moving. Keep working. We have to establish your name. Well, that is... What is it? I've started composing it, but... Oh, Arthur, I'm stuck. I'm horribly, horribly stuck. I don't know how to complete it. Wilma, don't say that. We've come so far. Everything we've worked for. I can't bear to let you down. I know what's wrong. It's the pressure from the Institute. Everyone clamoring for your attention. Recognize you on the street. And even more pressure from me. Vienna is a city. We can't change that. You need a change, that's clear. Listen, I have a cabin in the mountains. You will be able to work there. Kind of like that one. No, you've done too much for me already. Nonsense. Your teaching, guiding me. Your help with the scholarship. You need time alone. The quiet. Yes, quiet. I'll take care of things here. Arthur, I can't. I'm not asking. It's settled. The carriage will pick you up tomorrow. There are plenty of supplies in the cabin. This is really interesting. I enjoy the pixelated pack lightly. You're not bringing your old violin, are you? Of course I am. Playing that old violin relaxes me. You'll have to walk the last part of the way. It's quite a hike. I'll manage. Very well. I do think this is for the best. You'll be completely alone. No distractions. Somewhere in the Alps. Ooh. Oh, forest. Forest. Cabin. Rock. Rock path. Telephone pole. Mountains. Dark clouds. Oh, jeez. Wow. I'm not sure, like, what to choose, because you can, like... Ooh, hang over the mountains. Almost as if they are waiting for something. The wind is growing stronger. It won't be long until the storm is here. I'd better hurry. Almost there. Just a bit further. Wait, I... Just a few more steps. Phew. Oh, okay, is it? I have finally arrived. That's it, Arthur's cabin. Oh, Arthur, I hope so much that you're right. That inspiration is waiting for me down there. Forest? The forest up here is so dense. The trees are thick with needles. You almost can't see through them. What about telephone pole? Telephone poles. The only connection from this place to the outside world. Rock. It's so peaceful up here. This path leads up here to Arthur's cabin. Looks like a storm is brewing. I might just make it before the rain. This is interesting. The Lion's Song. I'm enjoying the music of it. She's really pretty. I like her look. I made it just before the rain. Hopefully it will stop soon. The walk up here was exhausting. Phew. Alright, Wilma, it's time to unpack your bag. The lamp casts a dim light. The flame dances quietly to and fro, and flares up briefly before subsiding. Is that like a weird shuffling sound? Locked. The composition is not finished. Oh jeez, oh wow, each book. Tonal Diversity by Professor Arthur Cabin. I didn't know he had written a book. A poetry book. There are several poems in it. Rilke, Hallman, Saul, and a few other authors. Let's see. Ah, here it is. The Panther. I will read it later. My violin. Telephone. I'm exhausted. There should be something to eat in my bag. This book is full of formulas. They describe the phenomenon of transformations. Like... I couldn't think of anything. Dusty. But empty. The drawer is locked. My bag. Myself. My violin. My old violin. Despite its battered appearance, it still has the most beautiful tone. My materials are in my luggage, okay. I'm starving. There should be a sandwich in here somewhere. Music paper. Ah, here it is. Oh, a letter. Who is it from? It says, open upon arrival. My dear Wilma, I hope you had a trouble-free journey. I'm sure you've started writing already, inspired by the beautiful surroundings. Yeah, I'll read on. However, I have a confession to make. Perhaps he has written something about us. She's all hopeful now. Before your departure, I started to organize. A concert at the Musikverein in Vienna. I was able to convince a few illustrious colleagues to offer their work. I had to call in many favors, but Mr. Schoenberg, Mr. Berg, and Mr. Mahler have all agreed to participate. It will be a glorious evening, and your composition will be the centerpiece. The grand finale. Wilma, imagine it. Oh, she just got like really sad. I understand that this is all very abrupt, and for that I apologize. But now is your time. The musicians start rehearsal next week. The piece must be ready by then. In anticipation of your return, Arthur. Oh, jeez. How is this less pressure? Arthur, how could you? The storm is almost here. How am I supposed to write something if I can't go outside? I'm trapped here, with a storm outside, and within me, silence. Holy shit, this just got like, oh, oh geez. Hello? J'étais Nico? Excuse me? Oh, German. Yes. With whom do you wish to speak? Anyone. My name is Leos. This is my first telephone apparatus call. It's an amazing machine, isn't it? Yes. Amazing. I wonder if... Are you close by? Where are you? I'm in the Alps. The mountains? Yes, those Alps. Ha ha ha. I never would have dreamed of this. I was told you can speak over long distances, but to actually hear a voice? It's amazing. She's a little impatient with this guy. I can now finally talk to my niece, Nicole. Stomach grumble. What was that? There's no way he heard that. What was what? That noise just now. How embarrassing. I hear this noise every day when my guests come to me with empty bellies. Are you an innkeeper, Leos? I am. Best dumplings in all of Bohemia. Wonderful when they're fresh out of the pot, with a rich, hearty sauce. That sounds really good. When you cut into one and the steam comes out, that sounds delicious. They are delicious. You have to come by one day so I can cook some for you. I wish I had some here right now. Of course you wish that. Oh, I like this guy. I apologize. It sounds like you are very hungry. It was a pleasure talking to you, madame. I'm very sorry. Where are my manners? I didn't even ask your name. My name? Will you tell me your name? It's Wilma. It was a pleasure speaking with you, Wilma. Say, do you think we could talk again sometime soon? They gave me a number. 1255. Maybe. I hope so. Thank you for your call. Goodbye, Wilma. Okay. Time for my sandwich. This is really interesting. It's kind of like a point-and-click visual novel, I guess, is what you call it. But, oh, stomach rumbling. She's really hungry, so I guess I'll just go ahead and give her the sandwich. And then, in the next episode, we'll catch up where we left off. So, I hope you guys enjoy. I just wanted to give this a shot. And, I guess I'll catch you guys in the next video. Goodbye.